Okay, so this video is going to cover solving systems of equations by graphing, and this particular video is going to cover the special cases, the no solutions, the infinitely many solutions. So taking a look at our first example, we have our system here, and what we know about solving a system by graphing is that we have to graph our entire system. So here we have two equations. We'll be graphing both of these lines, and we need to figure out which case we have. And what I mean by that is that typically when you're solving a system, you have one of three cases. You have one solution, and that happens when your lines intersect at one point, and that is your intersection point here where they meet, and you have one solution to your system. You could also have no solution to your system if you have the case where your lines are parallel, which means they will never cross, never intersect, therefore no solution. Or you can have the third case where after simplifying or after putting the equations in the proper format, they actually end up being the same exact line, which means every single point is going to intersect, which means that is an infinitely many solutions. So this video is going to cover these two cases right here, the no solution and the infinitely many solutions. And taking a look, what does that look like graphically, or how can we tell? Because most of your instructions are just going to say solve the system or solve the system by graphing. It's not going to stipulate if it's the one solution or if it's one of these special cases over here. So we need to know, based off of our information, based off of our equations and our graph, which one of these do we have? Okay, so when it comes to graphing, the first thing we need to do is get our equations in the proper form, which means we need to put them in slope-intercept form. So, starting with the top equation, 3x plus 2y is equal to 5. We're solving for y here, so we need to move our x value over. Since that's a positive 3x, let's subtract 3x on both sides. It'll cancel on the left, drop down 2y is equal to, now we do want the x in front, so we're going to do negative 3x plus 5. And the last thing we need to do here is recognize, well, over here on the left-hand side, that 2y is 2 times y. So remember, when it comes to solving, we do the opposite of what we have. So instead of multiplying, I will be dividing by that 2, making sure that I divide everything in the equation by 2. On the left-hand side, it will cancel. Dropping down the y is equal to, well, a negative over a positive is negative. Otherwise, 3 halves does not simplify. So here we're left with a negative 3 halves x plus 5 over 2 does not simplify as well, so we're just left with the 5 halves there. And we're going to pause there for a moment while we get our second equation in the proper form. So here we have negative 6x minus 4y is equal to 5. Doing the same thing, we're solving 4y, so we need to get the x over. Since we have a negative 6x, we're going to do the opposite and add 6x. Making sure we do so to both sides. It'll cancel on the left, so we drop down the minus 4y is equal to putting the x in front again, so we get 6x plus 5. Last step would be to divide out the coefficient. So here our coefficient is negative 4, and we need to make sure that we divide everything by negative 4. Going ahead and simplifying that, negative 4 over negative 4 cancels. We drop down the y is equal to, a positive divided by a negative is negative. Otherwise, here we have 6/4, which does simplify down to 3/2. Remember, we have a 2 in common. So if we do 6 divided by 2, we get the 3, and 4 divided by 2 gives us the 2. Over here, our constant, we have a positive divided by a negative, which is negative. Otherwise, 5 divided by 4 is 5 divided by 4. That cannot be simplified. All right, so it looks like we have our two equations here, which are a little bit ugly just because of the fact that we do have fractions here, but they're still very much doable. One thing that you may notice about these two lines, so essentially when it comes to graphing, the reason why we're putting these equations in slope-intercept form is because as long as they're in the proper form, it tells us what our slope is, and what our y-intercept. And those are the two pieces of information that we use in order to graph. So typically we would start by graphing our y-intercept. So the equation on the left, that would be a 5/2. And then we would look at our slope, which is a -3/2. Taking a look at the equation on our right, we would have a y-intercept of a -5/4. But we also have a slope of a -3/2. So take a look at that. These slopes are exactly the same. Now, one thing that we want to remember at this point is that when we have two lines that have the same slope, they are parallel to each other. They have the same slope, so they do run side by side. Now, just looking at these equations and noticing that they do have the same slope does mean parallel. Parallel lines never cross. So just by that fact alone, because these lines never cross, they will never meet. That means they have no intersection points. We can say just by that alone that there is no solution to this system because we're talking about parallel lines. This was that second case. But if you do want to get a visual here so we can practice on drawing these here, the equation on the left has a y-intercept of 5/2, which if you change that to a decimal, just type into your calculator 5 divided by 2, that is a 2.5. So on our graph over here, we can go up 2.5 and put our y-intercept. From that y-intercept, we look at our slope, which is a -3/2. So first off, our line is going to be going in the negative direction, and we're going to be going up 3 over 2, up 3 over 2. So up 3, 1, 2, 3 over 2 gives us about right there. And I'm going to go ahead and connect the dots. Taking a look at our second equation, we have a y-intercept of a -5/4. Right. So another fraction as our y-intercept, but again, if we want to go ahead and plug that into the calculator, just do 5 divided by 4, we get about a 1.25. Do keep in mind that that is -5/4. So from the origin, we would go down about 1.25. Honestly, as long as we get close enough, we're good here. The slope is also a -3/2, so that means from that point, we'd be going up 3 over 2, up 3 over 2. So up 1, 2, 3 over 2. And we would connect the dots. Now having both of the lines graphed, we can visually see they are parallel lines. They will never intersect. There is no solution for this system. So we either noticed it algebraically by comparing these equations together, specifically their slopes, but then having graphed them, we can visually see that they're also parallel, parallel lines, no solution when it comes to systems. Okay, so we're still working on solving systems by graphing special cases. So here we have another example. And let's see if we can figure out which situation we have here. So since we're graphing, we do need to get our equations in the proper form. So I'm just going to drop down my equation so I can work with putting it in the proper form here. So 4x plus y equals 16. We need to get this in slope-intercept form, which means we are solving this for y. So for this particular equation, that means we need to move the 4x over. So we are subtracting 4x on either side. 4x will cancel on the left. Dropping down y is equal to -4x plus 16. Let's pause there while we work on the other equation, which is 16x plus 4y is equal to 64. Getting this equation solved for y, we need to move that 16x over. It's positive, so we would subtract it away. It would cancel on the left-hand side. We drop down 4y is equal to, we want the x in front, so we do -16x. So we do -16x plus 64. Now we need to finish getting this solved for y, so we need to divide out the coefficient. We need to divide all sides by 4. On the left-hand side, 4 divided by 4 cancels, leaving me with y is equal to. A negative divided by a positive is negative. 16 divided by 4 is 4. Drop down the x with it. plus 64 divided by 4 is 16. Okay, so let's take a look at these equations that we have here now that we have them in the proper form. On the left, I have y equals negative 4x plus 16. On the right, I have y equals negative 4x plus 16. They are the same exact thing. So they are the same equation, the same line. So this should hopefully be telling us that this is situation three, where they are exactly the same line. They fall on top of each other, which means every single point is going to intersect with each other. So in order to get a visual here, so visually we can see the equations are the same. This is case three, infinitely many solutions. But let's go ahead and practice graphing this one here. As much as we can, we do have a y-intercept of a positive 16. So here that is going to cross at a plus 16. Let me make my graph a little bit bigger just so we can have room to work with here. That's 16 right up here. So our line would cross at a 16, a positive 16, and from 16, we would be looking at our slope, which is a negative 4, which means up 4 over 1, up 4 over 1 in the negative direction, or down 4 over 1, down 4 over 1, down 4 over 1, and we can keep doing this till we have enough points. Here is our line. There's not really any point in graphing the other line. It's the same exact line. It would just land right on top of this one. Every point would intersect. So we can see by our equations, or we can see by our graph, that this system is infinitely many solutions because they are the same line. They share every point.